What I'd like to share with you today is how I made these tiny little wreaths. This one says Fairies Welcome, and they're just little embellishments to go on cards, picture frames, on your little journals, and they're really, really easy to make. This was that Easter one, so that says Happy Easter, and this is just like a little primitive one with a little heart made out of a book page and a little bit of wire and some of the raffia. So I will show you how I've been making these this morning. I'll pop those over to the side. And what we need is, this is the start, and I'll show you how I've made these. This is from raffia. Okay, so I'm sure we've all got a little bit of this in our craft storage somewhere, in our stash. So I've just got some lengths of this. You don't need a huge amount. It does go everywhere. And what you do to make the little rings is just grab a it comes in its own lengths, so it's a standard length. So just take it in your hand and just wrap it around a couple of times, so you've got like a general circle, and then take it and then wrap it through. Oops, don't want the ribbon yet. And you just pop it through, pop it quite tight. So you're wrapping it round. Round and round. And then you can feel it because it's getting a bit quite sturdy. And just tuck all the little bits in. Pop them round and round. And then what we do at the end, we just glue gun it. So it's got a little bit of glue on there just to hold it in place, so you can go around. If you've got any little straggly bits, you can always just cut them off, so these can go just round and round. There we are. What I'm going to do is just glue gun that. Let me just go around and just try and tuck that end in. There we are. So take a little bit of glue, pop it on there, look, and hold that down. And just chop the excess off there, look. There we go, so then we've got another little ring. So that's how easy they are to make. So that's, you can make them bigger, you can make them smaller. But this side I thought is ideal for, even if you want to make a little fairy door and put these on it, like this one. So that's lovely, you can have a little hanger popped on there, depending on what you would like to do with it. So what I'm going to show you now, I'm going to make, and these embellishments here and on this one here, oh, I'm sure everybody also had these, which are the little butterflies with like the netting. I think these I've had for years and years, and all I did to sort of make them a bit trendier, I put some gesso on it. So I've just painted them with gesso, and this one I've just added some glitter. So this is what we're going to be popping on this one today. So I'm going to take that, and then I've got some ribbon, and this is what I've just hand dyed. It's some of the seam binding. So I've just dyed these myself. So what I'll do, I think we'll have a nice light pink one. I'm going to make a little bow to pop on the bottom. These are just really, really quick. I do like quick projects. So once I've done it all, they are quite quick to pop them all together. Once you come up with the idea. So that's probably about the right size. So we'll just chop off the bottom like that. Oops. Runcle up the bottom so it's all nice and shabby. Like I do. And these obviously can be any length as well, if you like the bottom. There we go. That's what I've done with it. So I'm going to just pop a little bit of this around it as well. I'll just glue that on. And then wrap this around. Do it as neat or as untidy as you like. As you know, I quite like mine all shabby and rustic. Pull these through here. Like that. Pop a little glue there. Stick that down. There you go. Off. Not put a glue everywhere. And where that glue is, we can just pop the bow. There, so we know where the bottom edge is. There we are. And then, what I did, I just printed out some wording on the computer. We'll make this into a little birthday one. So I'll just chop that out over there. Let's see how big. So we could do this, couldn't we? And then you just pop it, you can pop it onto a little slanty angle, a little bit of glue on here. So it's like that side. A little bit on here. Like that. Oops. Okay, let's see what we've got in here. I can pop on there. Tiny little pink heart. Heart in the middle of the bow here. Look at that. Oh, this is upside down. There we go. And I can pop another little one. So that's a really quick embellishment to pop onto a birthday card. That was nice and easy. I'll pop that over there. And what I'm going to show you now is how I made the wire. So this one's made out of wire, which is just green garden wire, which is like this one. So what we do, we just take a length of wire. Doesn't matter, depends how big. This is probably about 60 centimetres. Same sort of principle, wrap it round so you sort of like get a circle. You can wrap it round a couple of times like that. Try and sort of bend this one in like there. And then just bend it and twist it all willy-nilly ways round. It doesn't really matter how. Just so you get the circle. Like this. That's nice and tight. There, and that's how you make the circle for that one. If you've got any wire, any colour wire you can use this with, even just the normal garden wire, you can do that. And this one I just wrap some ribbon around it. So what we can do is wrap a little bit of the pink. This gives you a more substantial wreath. So you can cover this up completely. Go. So that's all wrapped around and covered. So we'll pop a little bit of glue on there to make sure it doesn't undo. There we go. Chop that off. Oops. Okay, so that's on there. So that looks nice. Glue everywhere. So what we can do, we can make another pink bow, or you can just, if you've got any little ready-made bows, you can use those as well. I'll pop these down like this. Shabby them up at the ends. Oops. Go. Pop that on there. It's a more sort of delicate one, isn't it? Looks a delicate one. Even if you've got like a gift bag, you could tie a piece of ribbon and hang it from the gift bag. And then it's an extra little gift for the receiver. Okay, and then what we're going to do, we're going to pop one of our little butterflies right on in the middle there, look. And there we go. So that moves it even quicker. There's one more I was going to show you, because I was thinking maybe we could turn one of these into like a wedding one. So I do have some silver bits and pieces here, which are these lovely little sprays which have got little pearls off them, which are wire wrapped. If you can't get hold of these, I'm sure you could probably make them with some very thin wire. So what I was going to do is take this off. Just wrap the ribbon around, stick this on here, look. Put that around. So these can be made for any occasion, birthdays and all sorts. Do it with all sorts of colours, anything. So, but I thought I'd do a nice silver one for a wedding. Which, if you find out, if you wanted to do one of these for somebody's wedding, you could just find out what their colour theme was, and you could make one the same colour so it all matches in. Chop that off. It's quite Christmassy as well, actually, this one. What I was going to do, I was going to take two so that they go this way. Okay, so the best way to do this is put them together, I think. Twist this round. Just chop the end bit off. Well, that's handy. And these are little brads I've got. Oops. I can get one out. That's a nice one. The little brads with holes in. So that should. Oh, pretty. Go in there. Oh, that's nice. Put that on the middle to finish that bit off. You can cover the whole of the wreath in the silver if you wanted to, if you didn't want it to be the raffia to show through. But I quite like that. If they've got like a rustic themed wedding, it would look really pretty. And then you could even put kisses on there, look. Pop that through, like so. So there we go, there's a few little of them that I've made. So I hope you like those and I hope you're going to give it a go. Here we are. So if you do like what I make, please do subscribe to my channel. And a big thumbs up will be fantastic, and I will see you next time. Thank you very much. Bye bye.